welcome to week 5. Today's toy today is the dinosaur. Dinosaurs were big, strong, and powerful creatures. They were wild and untamed. There was no way to control them. But if one man in history could tame a dinosaur, it would have to be today's Bible hero. His name was Samson. Samson was given the gift of super strength by God, and he used that strength to help his people fight a wicked enemy. Let's take a look.
I'd like to tell you about a fella, the guy was really strong. Samson was an Israelite who never got along. God gave him a mission, God said don't cut his hair. When Samson came a-coming, there was trouble everywhere.
One day a lion jumped me, so I grabbed the vicious beast. When the fighting was all finished, the lion was deceased.
The Philistines had captured Israel, but God devised a plan to rescue all the Israelites, and Samson was his man.
Don't forget Samson, though you're big and strong. Your power isn't just because your hair is long. God give you your strength, you've got a job to do. God is gonna do a mighty work through you.
I caught 300 foxes, and once the tails were tied, I set them all on fire until everything was fried.
The Philistines got angry.
We thought we'd take him down.
I killed 1,000 of them with the jawbone lying around.
Though God was using Samson, Samson had a vice. He hung out with evil women if he thought that they looked nice.
I sure like Delilah. I want her as my bride.
I promise to be faithful and to never leave your side.
Don't forget Samson, though you're big and strong. Your power isn't just because your hair is long. God give you your strength, you've got a job to do. God is gonna do a mighty work through you.
They gave her lots of money to see what made him strong. Every time she tried to trick him, she found that she was wrong.
Until the never-ending nagging, I could no longer bear. I told him about my secret, that my strength was in my hair.
Samson was asleep, she shaved his hair till it was gone. When awoken by the Philistines, Samson wasn't strong.
The Philistines are now upon you, I shouted out with glee.
We poked Samson's eyes out so that Samson couldn't see.
Don't forget, Samson, you were big and strong. Your power wasn't just because your hair was long. God gave you your strength, you got a job to do. God's still gonna do a mighty work through you.
They threw me in prison and made me grind grain. Then they threw a huge festival to their false god Dagon to celebrate my capture. When they brought me out to make fun of me, they didn't notice my strength came back. And guess what else came back? Let me rest between the pillows.
Did something start to shake?
What is Samson doing?
Watch the pillows break!
The place began to crumble. Thousands now were dead. God did it with a fellow with long hair upon his head.
Forget Samson, he was big and strong. His power wasn't just because his hair was long. God gave you talents that he wants you to use. God is gonna do a mighty work through you.
Samson had taken a special vow of service to God. And as part of that vow, he vowed he would never, ever, ever cut off his hair. Samson was so proud, he truly believed he could fight off the Philistines without God's help. He told Delilah, his Philistine girlfriend, about his hair, and as soon as she cut it off, his power left him. Samson lied to Delilah twice before he told her his secret. What he should have done was the first time was run. But Samson was too proud to run. Samson trusted his muscles to save him from his enemies and disobeyed God. When someone tries to tempt you, run from temptation. God knows that we're all sinners and we're all gonna make mistakes, but God wants us to fight temptation as hard as we can. All right, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible verse. Last week, we tried to repeat our Bible verse with our eyes closed. This week, we're gonna try to repeat our Bible verse while holding our tongues. Ready? Let's see if you can do it. Grab your tongue, here we go.
Liebe, eine Weile im Kreis. Ich wohne nun in der Pfarrerde. 5 Korinther 12, 27.
Whoo! That was hard. Did you do it? Great job, boys and girls. This week's bottom line is, when I play, I can remember that temptation means I should turn away. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for loving us even when we sin. Help us to fight temptation to realize that we aren't strong enough to say no on our own. We are sinners, and the best defense for us is to run from temptation. We praise you in your Son's name, and all God's children said, Amen.
No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart. No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart. You see when I'm sad. You see when I'm mad. You still love me and you want to help. When you look in me, I want you to see L-O-V-E, love for my friends and family. No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart. No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart. Sad. You see when I'm mad, you still love me and you want to help. When you look in me, I want you to see L-O-V-E, love for my friends and family. No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart. No matter what I see, God sees the inside of me. The Lord is looking at my heart.
Can see hey, oh, hey, oh. The wonderful things you have for me. Hey, oh, hey, oh. Open my eyes so I can be hey, oh, hey, oh. All that you have planned for me. Head up, head down. Hey, oh, hey, oh. Arms to the sky, arms to the ground. With it.
can see. The wonderful things you have for me. Open my eyes so I can be. All that you have planned for me. To the sky, arms to the ground. Come on now, spin around. Stop. Rocky monkey with it. Head up, head down. Arms to the sky, arms to the ground. Come on now. Get with it!